Let's have some fun with water. This is a glass of water and a piece of newspaper. I have placed it over this and then I'll turn it. I'll remove the newspaper carefully and the water is not falling. The water is not falling. That when you take a piece of cardboard and place it on the water and then place it upside down, when you remove, the water doesn't fall. Because air exerts pressure on this cardboard from all the sides, which is capable of balancing the weight of the water and it doesn't fall. The same thing is happening here, but I've played a trick. Actually, I've taken this transparent sheet of the same size and then placed it. I hid it inside the newspaper and then did it. And you see that the water is not falling due to the air pressure. Thank you.
See the change. The arrow's direction is changed. When we see these arrows through the water, the direction has changed. Actually, this glass full of water is acting as a convex lens. It is acting as a convex lens. You want to understand what is a ray diagram and how this happens? Okay. Let's understand the science behind this with the help of this ray diagram. Actually, these objects, arrows, are here. And this is a glass full of water which is acting as a convex lens, and then the image formed is obtained here. Light rays passing through here and then they converge here, coming from here, converges here, and then we see here at this place the image is formed inverted. So here in this case, this glass full of water is acting as a convex lens.
Observe this carefully. Are you able to see a fish inside the container? Okay, it is visible. Now you have to observe carefully when I place inside the water. Are you able to see the fish? You can't see the fish? Fish has disappeared. Okay, now I bring it up. The fish is still here. I've not done anything. When I place it inside, the fish is not visible. So why does the fish disappear? So the fish is here only. This happens due to the phenomenon of light, refraction of light. And the light ray goes from denser to rare medium. They change their path. And in this case, they change their path that they bent away from the normal, because actually there is air inside this container. And they bend in such a way that the position changes.
Hello everyone. Do you want to make rainbow at home? See it there. What do you see on the wall? It is a spectrum of 7 colors. And it is the most fascinating activity which I have done till date. We don't need actually anything for this setup. We require just a ball of water and a plain mirror. There are two phenomena happening when the light ray enter to this water. It is actually going from rare to denser medium and they bend, disperse, and from the mirror the reflection will happen and you see a rainbow on the wall. For more details, you have to watch my another video in which I'll be explaining this whole process, that how does it happen when it goes into the raindrop. Thank you so much.
Okay, so I have taken a lit candle and a transparent glass. You can take a transparent bottle or anything else also. Now I'll place it upside down and you have to observe the level of the water carefully. Have you seen the water level rising up? Okay, now we have to understand, but why does it happen? Actually, the air was here inside and oxygen is required for combustion. So when the candle was burning, oxygen is consumed and carbon dioxide is released. Now when it extinguishes, it starts cooling. The gas starts cooling and the cold air compresses. Cold air requires less space, and that's why the water from outside moved inside, because inside the pressure reduced and the water moved from high pressure to low pressure. So that's why the water level has risen up.